Greetings and welcome to Youtique Bridal and Lifestyle Designs. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create the Infinity Chapel Veil, which completely frames your face, and the Triangle Chapel Veil, which just simply falls over your head and lies along the side of your face. So let's get started. Here are the ordinaries you will need in order to complete this project. If you need more time, feel free to press pause and review the list. This is just a side note. I had used this lace trim because it had a double lace trim along the edge, and that would allow me to trim it down and make a longer lace trim. Now to create the Infinity Chapel Veil, I will be making two measurements. Because I want the veil to go over my shoulders, I'm going to take the measurement around my shoulders. I measured it at 36 inches, but I'm going to add about 4 inches for ease. So that will make it 40 inches total. The next measurement is the length of the veil, and I measured it and wanted it at 23 inches. So my shoulder measurement is 40 inches and the veil length is 23 inches. I'm going to cut the fabric at 40 inches wide, which is my shoulder measurement. Now I'm going to open up the fabric and then trim off the lace at one end. Next, I'm going to fold the lace fabric in half and then measure 23 inches down from the lace trim on the other end. This is the measurement that I wanted the length to be. I will open up the fabric and then pin the lace trim that I had cut earlier onto the bottom edge. You can start hand sewing or take it to the sewing machine like I did and then follow the lace pattern. Next, fold the fabric in half and sew a French seam. Here's how you sew a French seam. I will be using a different thread color so you can see how the seam is encased. I will lay the fabric on top of each other with the wrong sides facing each other. And I will sew it with a 1/4 inch seam. Next, trim it down to about 1/8 inch seam. Open up the fabric and fold it around to encase that seam. Sew it at 3/8 inch seam. Now the seam is encased and it looks clean. I like to finish it off with a quick iron. And now you have a beautiful French seam. To finish off the veil, I'm going to sew the hair clip opposite the side of the seam. And now you are complete with the Infinity Chapel Veil. You can wear it as a lovely scarf, and here I'll be showing you how to wear it as a veil. With the hair comb at the top of the veil and at the back of the opening, you're going to slip into the veil. Pull it over your head and then slide the hair comb back and snap it in place. And now all you have to do is just straighten out the veil. And this is your Infinity Chapel Veil. For the Triangle Chapel Veil, I'm just using 1 yard of lace fabric and taking 1 measurement. I will be measuring the length of the veil point, and I wanted mine at 28 inches. First, I'm going to open up the lace fabric and then fold it in half lengthwise. I'm going to slide it around to make it easier for me to cut. At the 28 inch mark, I am going to start cutting at an angle all the way to the end of the lace edge, and I will set that fabric aside. With the other side of the fabric, I'm going to trim off the lace edge. I am going to cut and separate the lace trim so that I will have more length. Now open up the triangular shaped lace, then lay the trim along the edge of the lace and pin. You can now hand sew it, or you can take it to the machine. And you are now complete with the Triangle Chapel Veil. To wear it with a hairpin, I center and lay the veil over my head. Simply place the hairpin through the lace. The other option is to sew in a hair clip. It would snap in place, and you are complete with the Triangle Chapel Veil. I just want to take this time to thank everyone who inquired about the chapel veil or requested a chapel veil tutorial. Because of you, I did research on the reasons why to veil. So I decided during Holy Week that I would start veiling during adoration and morning prayer. Thank you for inspiring me to learn and go deeper into my faith. Well, thank you for visiting, and I hope you got inspired to create something extraordinary out of the ordinary.